Okay, how many people were here at the bash? So a lot of you guys might know some of this stuff. So some of it might be a little repeat. Some of it will have more details, obviously, since we've started 2017, and there's a few new things too. So, and I thought what we'd do, we're gonna go through. We have some questions. We're not gonna, you know, I know it's scheduled too, but we won't go that long, and then we can go outside, look at the cars after, if you have any more questions, one-on-one. So let's put a wrap on 2016. This is the stats for 2016 model year. 40,689 2016 Corvettes were built, and that is of the most since 1984 for a model year. And you may know, a lot of people know that 1984 was more than 1 year of production. It was an extended year. So it's really the most of a normal 12-month model year since 1979. So thanks to everybody that bought a 2016. And you can see, you know, we got the coupes, convertible, Stingray Z51, Z06. You know, we did, quite a few, you know, over 14,000 Z06s, which is a record also. And we've actually built between, you know, think about it, we had like the Z06 launched in the middle of 2015 year, like towards the end of 14 calendar year. So about 1.5 years, we're around 20,000 Z06s for this generation. The C6 generation, we built 8 years of Z06s, and that number's around 26,000. So by 2017, we'll already pass 8 years of C6 generation Z06s. So big success. Some of the other interesting things, a lot of red brake options, a lot of black wheels did really well. And here are some of the Z06 options. You see a lot higher on the competition seat. The Z07 package with ceramic brakes, 35%. Carbon fiber does really well. Black wheels, very popular. I know there's this black wheel versus chrome war on the forum. I mean, we like them both, whatever you like, but the black wheel people are winning. But, you know, chrome's hanging in there, so don't feel bad either way. One of the things I wanted to remind everybody, we came out with this in the middle of the year. It's going to continue in 2017, and I don't think a lot of people knew about it. I heard a lot of people say, I like the ceramic brakes, but I don't want to go full out Z07 package with the cup tires and everything. So you can get on a Z06 just a ceramic brake option separate, and we're going to continue that to 2017. So you can just order, it's code J57, and it'll upgrade the brake system without going to the full cup tires. Rather have it that way. Here's our colors. Kai was in here before, like he said, over 20%. Arctic white is the number one color. You know, we do all the, you know, it's kind of funny. I love all the new colors. Everybody loves what new colors are coming out every year. But every year, you know, the top three colors are the oldest colors we have. You know, Arctic white, black porch red, classic colors, of course, classic Corvette colors, those always do the best. And then on the interior, there's black and red. Red interior does really well. I even have like cross-referenced. I got this on the chart later if you wanna look your car up, you know, in the outside. But you can see like for example, white car and the white Stingray with red interior is really popular. So you know, you can see all the different combinations. And you've got a few real rare cars like we came out with the Admiral Blue at the end of 2016, right? It was like only available for the last couple of months. And with the brownstone interior, there's only one Stingray and one Z06. And that's all they'll ever be because we don't have brownstone in 70s. Let's go who brought those cars. They got one each, one-off versions. The C7R edition, they really all sold out pretty quick. You can see, you know, we have about two-thirds were automatic, two-thirds were yellow, 88% coupe, mostly coupes versus convertible. I got this all broken down if you have one. If anybody has one, congratulations. I know one, at least. And then I got some questions on the design packages. We sold 1,360 of the total of the three design packages put together. The spice red was the most popular, 535. And you can see the breakdown of all, you know, each one was available in four colors. I have that chart outside too. You don't have to, don't worry if you don't have a pencil to write down yours right now. We can, look that up too. But again, we'll keep track. It's fun to keep track of all this stuff. And then, of course, you know, our big competition, you know, not just racing, but in the showroom, Corvette, so far this year, this is through July. August just finished, and we had a good August. But we're still maintaining 40% of the what we call the luxury sports car segment, even though the segment is that we are a little, sports cars a little bit down this year versus last year. But we're still more than holding our own against the best of the world, the best the world can throw at us from Europe. We're happy to compete with them and beat them, which we've been doing. Of course, the competition on the racetrack, we got two races to go. We got three wins in a row, which is really exciting. With the 100th win at Lime Rock. Everybody saw the Road America finish. That was exciting. If you didn't see that, that was a, you know, fifth to first in the last few minutes of the race as well. We you can see this exciting finish in the top corner. We had to start the season off in Daytona. Can't always be between both us two up front, but what an exciting finish that was. I actually, you know, Oliver Gavin, it was Oliver Gavin versus Garcia at the end. And like, aren't you guys worried you're gonna hit each other or take each other out, you know? And he goes, well, I really wanted that watch. the Rolex. So that was all about the watch, that last lap. Who gets it? And now that he has it, he wears it proudly and shows it off, rubs it in Garcia's face. Look what I got. So we got two races to go, good chance of winning the Manufacturers Championship and Drivers Champion. So hopefully we'll finish off. And then the prototype car too is doing really well. And here's the big, our big 100 win team shot. A lot of fun. I just bought a 100 win shirt at the museum store. You think they'd give me one, right? But I'm here to support. So what's new for 2017? Actually, the first U.S. showing of the Grand Sport was at Sebring. Got this shot. With the Admiral Blue car with all the drivers right on the track. So let's go into the Grand Sport. As you know, this is the fourth iteration of the Grand Sport. Started in 1963. Was supposed to be a racing factory-built race car that Zora wanted to build 125 of them, but they cut them off. They only allowed them to build five. And they slapped them on the wrist. Probably if we did something like that today, we weren't allowed, probably would have got fired. So it's a good thing that Zora stayed with us. 1996, a special car, only 1,000 were made. The last year, the fourth generation car. 2010, we actually introduced that car right here at the museum for the first time. Anybody saw it? And kind of a dark time. It was kind of exciting to do something. Nobody expected us to do anything new. For then, we really brought out the Grand Sport as a new model because, as you remember, the Z06 in those years was hardtop, fixed roof, manual only, and so a lot of people wanted, you know, you could get that aggressive chassis, the wider body, but you could get it in manual, automatic, coupe, convertible, so it really opened up, became our best-selling model for the C6 generation at the end of the years. And now we're bringing it back as a seventh generation car. Well, here's more detail about what we're just talking about. And the reason we did that, you know, when we came up the seventh generation Z06, one of the things we wanted to do and what we did was we had the removable roof coupe. Again, we have the convertible, we have manual, we have, you know, paddle shift automatic. So we thought maybe we don't need to bring the Grand Sport back. But like I said, it was about 5 seconds after we showed the Stingray, people were like, are you going to do a Grand Sport seventh generation car? So you know, maybe we should. See, it really captures the sweet spot. This is a neat picture. That's Bill Towers' car. That's the fifth Grand Sport number 5 with a 5, and that's our collector edition car. This was at Atlanta Motorsports Park, and the clouds were rolling in. He was kind of worried his cars could get rained on. It actually did a little bit, but we got this probably a once-in-a-lifetime shot was the clouds are rolling in to get those two cars together at our launch. So let's talk more about the Grand Sport. Again, it's its own model, coupe and convertible. You probably know about this. Some of the things, it has, of course, specific interior plaque, some specific package, heritage package, and the collector edition, which I'll go into more. And there are 5 different wheels available. Some of the things that are standard on the Grand Sport, you should know. Of course, the wider tires. Rear tires are 335, 25, 20. It's got the large brake package, 14.6-inch front, 6-piston. It's got the 7-speed manual with the ratios from the Stingray Z51, so the quicker ratios. And also the 8-speed has the quicker 273 axle ratio from Z51. Dry sump system, magnetic ride, control is standard, ELSD is standard. And for the first time on the Grand Sport, we have a Z07 package optional, which gives you the ceramic brakes and the cup tires. So it really makes it a true 1.2G car. Really incredible for a street car. And actually, at the Atlanta Motorsports Park, we were doing, it's one of these country club tracks, but a lot of rich people own it. I think it was built on Bill Elliott's property. And we were running cars. Actually, Andy Pilgrim drove. We had Andy Pilgrim out there, and he was working for Automobile Magazine. Oliver Gavin was out doing hot laps. And one of the owners of the track saw, what are you guys getting for laps? And we showed him, and he says, well, that's the track record for a production car. And then you think about the rich people that are there and the cars they have. So we weren't really attempting that, but it was pretty cool for the Grand Sport. And I said, you know, we have a car that's even faster than this, too. All the Z06, so. But it was pretty cool to do that. Just on the exterior design forefront, it has the lower hood, like the Stingray, so it's good for visibility, doesn't need the tall hood, no supercharger. Satin black Z06 style grille, the red tail lamps, like the Stingray. It's got the quarter ducts, like the Z06, they're about that body color. It's got wider quarters and fenders. It has its own unique fender duct and cove area, which is always a good way to identify Corvettes. And then one of the differences is when I mentioned the Z07 package, because it's less horsepower than a Z06, we're not requiring the ground effects package. So at certain tracks, actually it benefits from the lower drag versus downforce. So it doesn't need as much downforce as the Z06 does with its 650 horsepower. And we have 5 different wheels available. You can see those outside. We have 3 of the 5 out there. We have the standard pearl nickel, black, and machined. Those are outside. And we also have a chrome, and we have a red stripe wheel. And this is what we call a cup wheel. This is really, the cup wheel is really one of our favorite wheels. It's very lightweight and strong, and really good for the focus of this car. It really fits in. And as you see, we have a new standard aerodynamic package that's shown here that's standard on both the Grand Sport and the Z06 with a standard rocker. This is what you get. If you don't get the carbon fiber ground effects, you still get a rocker standard now, which is good for both ground effects and helps protect the body side from stones and things like that. So optional is the Heritage package. And like I said, I have people say, oh, do I have to get stripes on a Grand Sport? Of course not, but you might want to, and that's why we have the Heritage package. And it started off, with the Admiral Blue, red, white car, of course, is the 96 design, but we really want to make it open up to a lot of different possibilities. So we have 6 different possible colors that you can get the hash marks in. It also comes with some interior features. The aluminum buttress in the interior has hash marks. I got to show you a picture of that. And you get the special floor mats. And then you can also, on top of that, if you like, get a center stripe as well. So you can get it with or without the center stripe. And again, here's an example of the Admiral Blue car, the one we have outside. And here's the six Ashmark colors you can get: red, torch red, carbon flash, volcano orange, chartreux, yellow, and hyper green. Hyper green is kind of like almost like a highlighter, you know, it's like an acid green almost. And here's the interior, see the format, and then, you know, the grab handle area, can everybody see that, the little stripes that are into the aluminum piece? That's kind of a neat little touch that you get with that package. And what we did was, so you think about all the different combinations with six hash marks, 10 colors, five stripes, with or without. There's basically 360 combinations right there. And so what we decided to do, you know, to help everyone, of course you can get whatever you like. But I asked Kirk in design, we kind of worked on this, to come up with kind of our top 10, just for, you know, customers like yourselves or dealers to help with the ordering. Here's ones that we know that we like, but again, you can go crazy and order whatever you like. And here's the 10. So for example, these are just examples, of course, the Admiral Blue, Torch Red and White, Arctic White, Torch Red and Blue. So it's kind of the other car flipped around. We have this car, we use this car a lot at Carlisle. It's very, I ask how many people like it. You realize how many people are Americans. You have to like it. It's American. There's black with gray and red. So white with the orange and carbon flash in the center. Black car with yellow and gray. We don't want those. We pretty much ordered one of each of these. We have this car outside in the convertible. Sterling blue, red, and gray. Watkins Glen gray, red, and gray. There's another gray one with the hyper green. This is the car. Now you're going to see pretty soon car and driver lightning lap. We'll talk about that a little bit, but that's the car. The car we use looks like this one. And here's a red with white. Red with carbon flash and white. This is really a good one too. And here's a yellow with sharp gray and carbon flash. So those were 10. But again, just to give you ideas. Of course, you can really customize it. And then we have one that we did extra special. Collector edition. This is the car that's in the conference center, and also the one that we introduced earlier this year in Geneva. The collector edition is going to be 1,000 cars. It's a package for a $5,000 package, basically. It has its own VIN sequence. And we really, you know, since we brought Grand Sport back, we wanted to do something a little special, something new. And the neat thing about it is really the interior and the stripes with the tension blue. And accent stitching. It also has some of the heritage package features, special emblems on the steering wheel and silk plates, and carbon fiber trim. Here's the rear view of that car. Here's the tension blue interior. Again, very, very vibrant, vivid blue. Some more interior. The logo. And this logo actually is on all Grand Sports on the center interior plaque with inspiration. That's actually the number 2 Grand Sport. Kind of a top view of that. It's the embroidered quilted headliner and blue stitches on the shifter, steering wheel. Okay, so that's the collector edition. That hasn't started production yet. That's going to start probably around October, like this fall. Going to start, and then order, so start, it'll start being available to order next month. So, and it'll be limited to 1,000 cars. So if you're interested in that one, you've got only a few weeks to go, so you can order those. One thing we did too, I know a lot of people remember we had the C7R rendered cover. We also did this new this year, it's a Grand Sport rendered cover, so that it's actually printed on the car cover. So that's kind of a new accessory that's available. And like I said, we had the introduction at Geneva. Now, here's something you probably don't know. Since Taj isn't here, I can kind of tell you a story about what happened. Okay, so you see, that was where we introduced, that's the Geneva Auto Show. Now, they had it set up. Oliver Gavin was there. He kind of talked about racing, and they were practicing this all day yesterday. Dad would drive, get in the car, and it's the same car that's here, and drive it out on stage and stop it on a dime and get out and say, what do you think of my new car? You know, as a whole, it's a cool thing. So it's right before, so it's the day of the show, and you know, they're waiting for it to start, and the car's backstage, and Taj is waiting in it, and they said, it's kind of a warm day. He said, don't turn the air conditioning on. It's kind of warm in the show, because they don't want it, you know, condensation or dripping or anything on the floor. So Taj, you know, if anybody knows Taj, he gets kind of hot, you know, when it's hot out, you know, he's very efficient, so he gets a little sweaty. So he went outside behind the stage, you know, he went out in the back, you know, outside a few minutes before just to kind of cool off. And he went out, you know, no jacket, no phone, they didn't take the phone out of your pocket, no pass, nothing. So he's outside and he goes to get back in a couple minutes before and it's locked. And he's banging on the door and the people in there is like, the show's about to start, can't let anybody in here. And don't, really, I'm supposed to be in there, whatever, you know, no, sorry. And so he tries to get back into the show, he doesn't have his ticket, doesn't have his phone, they won't let him in. So he said there was a bunch of workers, you know, smoking outside by an open door. He basically snuck back in and got around and got in the car and drove it out, like, just in time. So anyway, so that's something you can see like in a movie, but that really happened. So, okay, so anyway, at the show, this was kind of the report back from the show, the Road and Track named it one of their, you know, they had all kinds of things at that Geneva show. The new Bugatti, the new Lamborghini, new Ferrari, new Aston Martin, everything like that. But our Grand Sport, they said number 2 of 10, I think one was the Bugatti Chiron, like the $3 million car or whatever. So we were pretty good. Yeah, the car was really well received there. Then some magazine articles are starting to come out. There's a Car and Driver, why it's the best all-around Corvette ever. Say this is the sweet spot, folks. Really pleased with the pricing. Road and Track, another car cover, best Corvette yet. They say he can feel the seconds drop off every lap, crazy for a car that costs about 75. It's an easy way to go fast, not passive like a Nissan GTR. It's not a video game. It's familiar and accessible in the right way. Familiar, revealing, given life and passion by professionals who love the tune just as much as we do. There you go. This is Autoblog. They said, want to be unfair? Call it a Park Spin Special or Z06 Lite. Go ahead, then drive it. This isn't merely an incremental improvement to make an already quick car a little bit quicker. It's a grander experience. The sweet nature of the V8, delightful throttle response, and permanent focus of a track day car, all in something you can daily drive. I think that really summarizes it well. This is Top Gear. They said, what is it like to drive instantly fun? You could commute in it and never realize what a track weapon you were sitting in. They said, is it just me or is Chevy on a roll right now? It does seem to be. And it says, should I buy one? An unreserved yes. It might not be the very fastest that you can buy, but if you like cornering more than just driving in straight lines, it's one for you. Enjoy. So that's from our friends at Top Gear, BBC. And here's Ars Technica. It's out of the park with the 2017 Grand Sport. I like this picture with all the different variety that we're showing, and they say, should you buy one? The answer is a resounding yes if you're in the market for a capable sports car that can do double duty touring the country or pounding laps at the track. It's cheaper than European rivals, but no less capable. It's the best Corvette yet. Kind of a theme, I think, we got going here. Then here's the R&T Online. They said it's the balance that for street or track. The jump to this Grand Sport is absolutely worth it. Suspension and chassis upgrades refine the car's handling. The Grand Sport does something amazing. It's stellar on both the road and the track. And so the Grand Sport then is more than a bad job, more than a cut race Z06, cut price Z06, more than a throwback homage to the Ghost of Zora. It's a total package, grip, power, and poised, all balanced and tuned to complement each other and work in harmony with the person behind the wheel. A performance car you can thoroughly enjoy on a closed course or out in the wild. And then Motor Trend, from muscle to balance, she does it all. car that can snap from soft and compliant to road-eating monster with just a flick of a wrist. It's the car Corvette you've been dreaming of. So anyway, I think they see the theme there. That's all written by people outside of us, so couldn't have said it better, though. I think we're getting some good reviews. So, okay, what else is new for 2017 on Corvettes in general? I think I went over like the colors, but in case you missed it, it's the Watkins Glen Gray, Black Rose. We have the Watkins Glen Gray car. Red is inside, a red stitch interior. You get red paddles, yellow stitch, you get yellow paddles. And brown stone, sorry. It's discontinued. Okay, so there's we have a new red seatbelt option. Here are the suede steering wheels and shifters. Here's the headliners. There's actually in the lower corner a picture of the Kalahari quilted headliner. And then the gray, or you can see another color key. Again, we have the gray convertible outside. You can see that one. And then electronics, we have what we call 2.6. That's the shop button. You can see the shop in the lower corner. It's basically what you call an app store. That's new for this year. And we had that idea for a while, but when all the cybersecurity came out, we waited until we really had that nailed down so it has all the latest cybersecurity protocol. And so it will allow you to buy certain apps. Right now, there's not that much on there, to be honest. We have like a weather channel app. And there's a books, audiobooks app. And I think we're going to have iHeartRadio, I think it's going to be out soon. So there's a few apps like that, but I think it's the beginning of something, I think that could be bigger years to come, where you could just really download new features and functions into the car and make your car more time-proof with new features now. The other thing we have for the performance data recorder, some new things. Again, we were the first ones to have that out and got a lot of feedback, and so we made some of those changes this year. The mute option for recording, a lot of people that were so excited when the car's recording, they might not have wanted all those expletives recorded. So you can mute that. And then enhanced recording screen, it'll show you which overlay. Some people, I recorded the whole thing, I didn't realize I didn't have my track overlay on. Now you'll know, it'll tell you which overlay you're using. It has an odometer, which is useful for the valet mode. You know, if somebody, you know how many miles they drove it. And then it'll also tell you what driver mode is displayed, you know, tracks. You know, some people like want to see, oh, was I faster on this course and track or sport? You might want to flip back and forth, it'll tell you which one that you did. Okay, Corvette Z06. We have a 2017 Z06 on display outside. Actually, first time we showed it was just last weekend at Carlisle. It's Black Rose. And the updates are pretty minimal, but they're significant. We do have a new supercharger cover design. What it did was a little bit higher and allowed us to slightly reposition the intercoolers for more efficient, and it really will extend the track performance. So if you are a skilled driver, like a 95% or above, in very hot temperatures, like 90s or 100 degree weather, you will notice a difference in how long the car will maintain its peak power when you're on the track. So, and then in addition to that, there's a new hood liner that was necessary to clear the higher supercharger as well. And all the engines from LT4 for the Z06 are now 100% built at the Performance Build Center here in Bowling Green. And a new option that's going to be available working with the National Corvette Museum is the combination of the engine build and the buyer's tour with one car. So in the same week, we're working so that we can schedule it in the same week. You can build your engine, and then a couple days later, you can watch it go into your car. So it's being built, so you get the full experience. And here's a kind of a performance, you know, like Zora said years ago, all Corvettes are high performance, it's just a matter of degree. So you can see, you know, how the performance levels of the Corvette. One of the things I want to point out, a lot of people are asking me about weight of the Grand Sport, And again, you know, you look at the forums, people think the car weighs 1,000 pounds more than the Stingray. It really doesn't. It only weighs 25 pounds more than the Stingray with Z51, which is the closest comparison. So the Grand Sport really does add a lot of capability for 25 pounds extra. And it is quicker, 0 to 60 and the quarter mile, with those very wide, sticky cup tires. And you can see Z06 still under, if you want to go under 3 seconds, Z06 is your choice. Here's our pricing that's been announced. Announced this a while ago, but you can see we have a full range of cars. For the Z06 pricing, so you know, how much is that going up? It went up $50, $50 increase. So that was it. So I mentioned this a bit ago. We did show this at the bash. This is from last year. You know, the car driver tested the Z06 at the Lightning Lap. See the headline, Corvette Z06 kills supercars dead, giant slayer. And the new issue is coming out next month. So I want to just everybody here to make sure you check that out. It's going to have the Grand Sport in it. And for example, okay, Marrow did a 241. You can't really compare his time to the, you know, it's different driver. You know, car and driver uses their own drivers. So it's about 3 seconds difference. He did the Z06. You can see where it is. It's actually the only car that they ever tested that was faster is the $900,000 918 Spyder. If you look at this chart, it's like a speed versus lap time. It actually shows that the Z06, based on its lap time, should cost about $500,000, but don't worry, we're not going to ask you for any money back. So I do have Merrill's VIR lap time in the Grand Sport. So I know some people probably have seen it, but if you, does everybody, show of hands, who wants to see it? Most of you, okay, so we're showing it. And, you know, I don't know if car driver, you know, probably a few seconds, but if we get, you know, below 250, and you look at the cars that this car's gonna compete with, you know, the GTR, the Viper, the Ferrari Italia, the Lamborghini, you know, so I think it's gonna fare pretty well. We'll see how it comes out next month in the article, but if they get within a few seconds of this time, it's gonna embarrass a lot of people, I think. Okay. So that was all I have for this, I think. So I think I'll open up. If you guys got any questions you want to ask right now, we answer those. One thing I do want to just remind everybody, the cars we have here, again, we have in the conference center, we have the collector edition, so check that out, that's the limited edition. Then outside, we have a black rose Grand Sport convertible. We have a sterling blue Grand Sport convertible. We have the Admiral Blue Grand Sport Coupe, and that's a 1LT car. That's kind of actually your ultimate all-go type of car, because it's a 1LT, so it's the lightest car, but it has a Z07 package for performance and competition seats, so that's kind of a neat car. And then we have a Black Rose Z06. I got the hood open so you can see the new intercooler cover. So make sure you check those out, but if there's questions, I can try to answer them.
No questions?
I don't know what to ask that you would actually answer.
See, you got guys trained. You're like scared to answer and ask anything. I guess Kai trained everybody. How many here were here for Kai's presentation? So you know about Hillary's server, how all our confidentiality was lost, and Hillary Clinton's server. And only Wes has access to him, and he's not talking.
I told you not to say that. I told you that in confidence.
Welcome to my world.
Arnold.
Yeah.
The track video, was that an automatic?
Yeah, good question. The track video is right off the car, performance data recorder. How many people have a Corvette with a performance data recorder? We got a few, so a few people know it. We came out with that in 2015, and we're the first in the industry to have that. It's your own onboard recording and telemetry device, and it creates videos just like that right from the car on an SD card, and you can plug that in, like we did. You can save the file and play it back. There's also a program called Cosworth Toolbox, we work with Cosworth on, that you can get even more detailed data on, just like your own personal race engineer. You get in there, you can really compare two different laps. You can compare your lap against Oliver Gavin's lap and see where you can make up time and things like that. It's really a great tool. Or you can just use it for fun on a fun road and record, you know, share with your friends. And it also has, if you haven't seen it, a valet mode. Now, nobody likes to valet park your Corvette, but some of these, you know, if you're in New York or LA, big cities, nice restaurants, you kind of have to. So you put it in this valet mode and it records whatever the car does without you driving it. So make sure you tell the valet that's recording them and be careful, because you're going to know what happened. You know, the Ferris Bueller Day Off thing.
Do you know who was driving that lap?
Yeah, that was Jim Merrow. He's the one that does our chassis engineer. And he's done the Nürburgring lap times you probably heard about, and VIR. He's probably our top Corvette driver that's also an engineer in the company. So he does an excellent job. And the neat thing about the Grand Sport that we heard from the media is not just that it's a fast car, it's very accessible. It's a very easy car to use at its limits. It's a right away people felt very comfortable in it. So I think that's one of the advantages of it.
And that was the Z07?
Yeah, well, it had the Z07 package on it with the cup tires and ceramic brakes. Yeah, back there.
Is the shop hat outward compatible for 15, 16?
That's a good question. Is the shop app, the shop app is not backwards compatible due to the cybersecurity things that we had input into the car. So some of that's hardware, so it's not backward compatible, unfortunately.
I did do the PDR download. Is that more, is that different than the download that I just got?
PDR? You mean like an upgrade, a PDR upgrade?
I did get the upgrade.
Yeah, we've had some PDR upgrade, you know, that you can go to the dealer, you know, and get updated. That helped the, it really improved the image quality, mainly.
Is there anything?
I don't think that one actually, I don't think that, that was done a little while ago. I probably didn't have it.
So that upgrade that I got is the latest and greatest that I could get, or are there new things that I can get upgraded?
No, I think you got the latest.
Okay.
Follow up on that. How many, I also got an upgrade, and the technician told me there was actually two at the time that I got it. This is last spring. So do you know how many there have been?
I think there's been two. How do you know you got the latest one? You get the new icon. You know, we changed the newer PDR icon, that's like the one, the older one had like a circular,
red dot.
If you got the newer icon, then you got the new one.
And if you don't, then you don't have the latest.
Right. The new one updated the icon.
So, what do you have to tell your dealer to get that?
Tell the dealer you want the latest PDR upgrade.
Well, I've got some stuff about, you gotta make a specific complaint so we can charge GM for this. No response.
Next
yes,
question.
Can't go there.
Yeah.
Is there been a shift in automatic transmissions and manuals now that the popularity and quickness of automatic is used to manual transmissions? You used to have a certain percentage of buyers.
That's a good question. Absolutely. Question, you know, as we've seen an increase in the automatic, absolutely. It's been especially since the 8-speed came out, we've seen a shift where more and more people are getting the automatic. A couple reasons, because we have paddle shift now, you know, as time paddle shift keeps getting better, so you get a lot of the fun of the manual in there. The other reason, like you said, the performance, the 0 to 60 times are better with the automatic as well. I think more and more people are getting more comfortable with the automatic. We tried to make the best manual we can too. We have the active rev match and things like that. So so the manual, you know, we're happy with the, you know, that the manual is still around for the hardcore people that want the manual. Kind of keep that around too. But we have seen a shift. You think about it, just a few years ago, like I was talking about before, Z06 was 100 and ZR1, 100% manual. You couldn't even get that. There's been a shift where people don't think about, like it used to be, oh, if you're getting a sports car, if you're serious, you have to get the manual. It's really not like that anymore. The new automatics are quicker shifting and you have the paddle mode, so the focus is now shifting to where they get the shifting, where the automatic can be the hot ticket too. So I think that's kind of a trend that's going where more and more. So the answer to your question is yes, more automatics.